Hello everybody, and you're also welcome to Heresy, your African history channel. My name is Vanessa Danso Chewa, and I will be your historian on this platform. On today's episode, we will be talking about the Akan Day Names, especially for our Friday boards, so for our Kufis and for our Ifiat. So I hope you like this episode, and I'll see you in the narration of the story. Going to be talking about something really interesting. For all my Ghanaian viewers out there, we all know that each and every single one of us carries a certain day name. Depending on the day you were born, of course, there is such a beautiful Asian symbolism embedded in our day names, so much so that finding the meaning of it touched me to my very core, and I just had to share this with all of you. So I would like to enrich your mind a bit more when it comes to the meaning of your Akan day name. Today, I'll be covering my Friday-born babies, my Friday-born kings, and my Friday-born queens. The week would be incomplete without your never-ending charm, so this one is for you, to the Ifias and to the Kufis. Just say you guys are too darn cute, the sweet pawpaws of the whole week. Anyways, not to worry, this is going to be a 7-episode series, so each and every single one of you will get their special information on their day of birth from Kwesiada all the way to Mimenda. I got you. Now I must tell you though, do buckle up because this will be quite extensive. So get comfortable because you're humbly invited to watch this to the very end. And finally, the day names given to us as individuals and their personality characteristics are more like a generalization. So it is perfectly possible that you may not necessarily fit into your characteristic box, which in that case only makes you perfectly imperfect in your own God-given unique way, which is nothing less than beautiful. Now let's get cracking. Now in order for you to understand this, I should tell you that we are going to go way back in time for this one. And when I say way back in time, I mean way back in time, all the way down to ancient Egypt era, or also known as ancient Kemet era. Now some of you may know this, but a great part of you may not, so here it goes. Christianity has not been around that long. This was only introduced to us around the 1600s by the missionaries. Now, do not misunderstand me. When I say it was introduced to us by the white people, that does not mean that it was created by the white people. So let's not get that twisted. Okay, so back to the story. Now, before Christianity became what it is today, in our Akan culture, our forefathers, our ancestors, they believed in deities, several gods, which has its roots all the way down to ancient Kemet or ancient Egypt era. This is a documented fact. They believed in spirits, or also called abosom in the Akan language. They governed the majestic solar, the astonishing lunar, and the infinite planetary bodies that govern the 7-day Akan week. These spirits operate through the many suns, moons, stars, planetary bodies, oceans, rivers, mountains, wind, fire, and the black substance of space comprising abodie or creation. They are the divine organs regulating order within the great divine body of Nyamiwa Nyame, just as your organs, your lungs, your heart, your kidneys regulate order within the greater body of you. It is from these Ekradim Bosom that Akan people derive our Ekradim or soul names, which are also called Dadi or day names. Now these Abosom are the deities. They are the goddesses and gods. They are the divine spirit forces in creation. And all of them together are referred to as Nyamiwa, Nyame, and Ma, the children of Nyamiwa and Nyame. Now Nyamiwa and Nyame were called Amenet and Amen in ancient Kanet and Kemet, which is today's ancient Nubia and Egypt, and they function together as one divine unit, the supreme being. Now why is it so important that I keep referring to the past, you may ask? Because we are more connected than you may realize. Well, it is believed that the Akans originated in ancient Kanet, or also called ancient Nubia, at the beginning of human existence upon Earth. This is a region of contemporary Sudan and South Sudan in the eastern region of Africa. We eventually migrated around the world. Some Akans migrated north of Nubia and settled in ancient Kemet, which is also called ancient Egypt, while others remained in Nubia. Over several millennia, Akans migrated to West Africa, establishing several Asian civilizations such as the Asian Ghana Empire, the Kanem or Pre-Bornu Empire, the original authentic Black Berber Empire, and the Kong Empire, before ultimately migrating to and settling in the areas of contemporary Ghana and Ivory Coast. Okay, so that was a little bit of geography there. Now let's get back to the story. Now, every Ekadi in Bosom has a specific function. And since this is the Friday-born edition, I will be discussing Ifi. Now, Ifi is a spirit responsible for the planet Venus, also known as Ifi. She's also responsible for Ifiada, which is called Friday. She's referred to as the wanderer, the traveler. She's adventurous, she's innovative, and she's creative. Ifi is a spirit who governs the sensual attraction, which is a precursor to sexual activity. She also governs the divine reproductive system, the procreative and creative structure in Abodie, the divine body of Nyamuwa Nyame, and thus the reproductive system within the African body. Ifi governs the fallopian tubes in the African female and the epididymis in the African male. She also governs the gestation process. Now, there's a striking similarity when it comes to spirituality and religion of over 2,000 years ago and Christianity today. For that, we will dive a little bit into Akan linguistics. According to ancient legend, Friday-borns are known to be very progressive, innovative, creative, and adventurous. Now, most of us also know that God himself has a day name, and this is Kwame. Now, Kwame is actually derived from Koyame, with the following syllables, ko, ya, me. Now, ko refers to life. The second syllable, ya, stands for a being with wisdom, like Nyansa, which means wisdom. And lastly, me, which comes from me, like after you're done eating, you could say my me, I'm full. It stands for satisfaction. Over time, the two syllables, ko and ya, merge into one word, kwa, and this stands for father of life, wisdom, life being, the creator. So Kwa is another basic name of God. This is the reason why all the male day names originally started with the prefix Kwa, but somehow with time, some got modified for convenience. Kwa is a prefix that will continuously return, so it is highly relevant that you remember it, as it stands for the Creator, our Heavenly Father. Now let's take a quick look at Genesis chapter 1 verse 24 to 31. And God said, let the land produce living creatures according to their kinds, the livestock, the creatures that move along the ground, and the wild animals, each according to its kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals according to their kinds, the livestock according to their kinds, and all the creatures that move along the ground according to their kinds. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make mankind in our image, in our likeness, so that they may rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, over the livestock and all the wild animals, and over all the creatures that move along the ground. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground. Then God said, I give you every seed-bearing plant on the face of the whole earth and every tree that has fruit with seed in it. They will be yours for food. And to all the beasts of the earth and all the birds in the sky and all the creatures that move along the ground, everything that has a breath of life in it, I give every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Day six, or Fiada, comes from Kwa Ufida. Now this can be split up in the following syllables, Kwa, Ufi, and Da. Now Kwa means creator. Ufi means home, which we know today as Ifie, and Da means day. On this day, God created the first home, namely the Garden of Eden, for man and woman. This also symbolizes coupled life. The first day man and woman lived together in one home. And this is very similar to the ancient Egypt Kemet symbolism. They already figured out and knew that day six of creation was about the image of man as well as woman, creating a home and bringing forth offspring. So you see, our ancestors were not far from the truth at all. The importance of reproduction of man being the sixth in creation was true 2,000 years ago and remained true after the Bible confirmed it so many years later. Now isn't that fascinating? Now a little bit of characteristics. Now Ifias are highly vibrant. They are hardworking, they are patient, and they have an enormous zest for life. They are disciplined when need be, but they are also quite intelligent. Besides all that, they may also be hard-headed, single-minded, and slightly stubborn. Furthermore, they are highly trustworthy, loyal, and dependable. Kofis are men with great ideals and ambitions. They have absolutely no limits when it comes to thinking big and having great ideas. On the other hand, they are also hard to follow and to figure out. Their interests are in the mysticism of things, strangeness and weirdness of stuff, and are therefore easily drawn to spirituality, psychology, politics, archaeology, and etc. So there you have it. Friday Borns, you guys are truly awesome. So don't you dare forget just how important you guys are.